Hello friends, namaskar. In today's video, I am putting up a very interesting topic before you, when to file a revised return. Since most of us must have filed their original ITRs by the date I am making this video for the assessment year 21-22. But at various times, you may feel that yes, there is a need of filing a revised return. And the probable questions which roam around this particular point are that, okay, when you can file a revised return, how to file a revised return, what point should be taken care of while filing the revised return, how many times we can file a revised return, and what are the interest, penalty, fee related consequences that are attached to a revised return. So all these questions I have tried to answer in today's session for your reference. So the first point, which is very important for all of us, is to understand what are the prerequisites for a revised return, that when a return can be revised. Are there any prerequisites for filing a revised return? Yes, sir. There are two prerequisites and they are provided under section 139, subsection 5 of the income tax law. They are, one, you should have filed a valid ITR. That is, a valid ITR is filed because there is an original return, therefore there is a revised return. So, if the first return is not valid, there is no concept of revised return. So, if you have filed a valid ITR, then there can be a revised return. Then the second point, which is very important, is that such ITR may have an omission or wrong statement. Now, what is an omission? That is to forget something to put in your return. And what is a wrong statement? To put something in the return which is not correct. So, if any of these two grounds are existing, then you should think of filing a revised return as per section 139, subsection 5. Now let me put up before you what are the various mistakes which lead to file a revised return. That is, when a person should think of filing a revised return, what can be the probable grounds for the same. That when a person claims wrong exemption. Say for example, many of us might be under the impression that the dividend income is still exempt. But with effect from financial year 2021, the dividend income is taxable in the hands of recipient, that is the shareholder. Now say if the practice was that dividend income was exempt and that is why I did not include the dividend in my ITR, then it is a wrong practice which I adopted in financial year 2021, that is, I am claiming a wrong exemption. So therefore, I need to think of filing a revised return including dividend income therein and to offer the same as taxable income. Other point, not offering taxable income in the ITR, like interest income, rental income, capital gain income. At times I have seen people don't offer or they forget to offer their saving bank interest in the ITR. Up to 10,000 it may work because the amount is not significant. But if it is beyond 10,000 in the case of an individual, it is taxable. And you are not offering, but such an information is appearing in AIS, that is annual information statement. You should certainly think of filing a revised return. Likewise, there are rental incomes which I have seen people are not offering in their return. They might have received such particular rent, maybe in cash or maybe in check, they should have offered it. Similarly, the capital gain income, at various cases it is found that it is not reported. And even at various cases I have seen people having capital loss from share market transaction, because more or less every Indian who is having some funds is nowadays inclined to do some share market trading. And in such a case, if you have done some such kind of transaction, you should have offered such capital gain or loss in your ITR. And therefore, in your original return, if you did not include such capital gain or loss, you should think of filing a revised return. Sometimes it happens that people claim wrong deductions. It could be a case of ATC, it could be a case of ATD. Say for an example, a person did not pay life insurance premium during the financial year. He paid it late with interest. And therefore, he is not eligible to claim it. But he included such particular amount in his deduction under ATC. That is a wrong deduction. Such person should think of filing a revised return. Offering income under lower tax rate. Say for an example, you have earned capital gain which is say taxable at the rate 20%, you are offering it under 10%. You have earned capital gain which is taxable at 20%, you are offering it under 15%. Such kind of issues may arise, and if such kind of things are there in your return, which is an original return, you should think of filing a revised return. Now let me put up one very interesting query here. whether filing of revised return attracts any penalty or fee? By default, my answer to this question would be no. But yes, when your original return is belated and which is being revised, and in the original return, which is a belated return, which is being revised, if any penalty, that is fees under section 234F of income tax law, is applicable, that may attract. But if your original return is filed in time, then even if you are filing a revised return beyond the prescribed time limit of 139(1), then no fee will be applicable under 234F. To exemplify this, let me say, for the assessment year 21-22, you file your return by 31st of December 2021 and say you've shown your total income to be nil. And now on 15th of January 2022, you feel that my total income is 10 lakh and you want to revise your return. You can do so without attracting any fee under section 234F of income tax law. One might also think about that whether the filing of revised return attracts any interest liability. Sir, certainly the answer to this question may be yes, because it depends upon facts and circumstances of the case. See, there are certain sections in income tax law regarding levy of interest, and pertaining to the ITR, they are interest under section 234A, B, C or D. So when they are applicable, say if your original return is belated one which you are now revising, and there is a period of delay in the filing of the original return to the due date prescribed in the law, then if you are revising your return and that too on an higher side, that is you are increasing your total income, naturally there can be a further extension of 234A interest. If there is enhancement of income, 234B would automatically increase. If there is enhancement of income, naturally 234C would also be applicable. And this is interesting point to know when 234D is applicable. 234D, my dear friends, is applicable when in original return you claim a refund that you have received, and while you are filing a revised return, your refund is reducing or getting converted into tax liability payable. Then law says you are supposed to pay interest at the rate 0.5% per month back to the department. So this is sometime 234D consequence may also arise. Now, I put up before you another question, whether total income may be reduced while filing revised ITR. Some people are worried about this thing, that in a revised ITR, I can't reduce my income to what I have reported earlier. There is no such notion, there is no such law, sir. You can enhance your income or you can reduce your income while filing a revised return. So there is no issue as such. If you feel that certain deductions which were to be claimed but not claimed, and you now want to claim them by way of filing a revised return, you can certainly claim them and you can claim the refund duly, and that should be allowed to you, no doubt about that. Yet I have answered this question earlier, but let me specifically answer it here again, that can a belated return also be revised? Sir, as on date when I am making this video, it is available in the law. The option is that if you have filed a belated return, that too can be revised. So no doubt, even a belated return, say for example, assessment year 21-22, I filed my first return on 2nd January 22. And on 5th of January 2022, I think that I should revise my return. I can do so, no problem in doing so. This one is an interesting question. How many times a return can be revised? The answer to this question is that there is no number limit provided in the law that for how many times you can file a revised return. It is up to the assessee to think as many times as he or she finds an error or omission in the return, return can be revised. But usually it is suggested that frequent filing of the revised return or revising a revised return, then again revising the same, should be avoided. So while you are filing the first revised return, you should think of that, okay, all other errors which are in your mind or which you can point out in original return are duly corrected in the first revised return itself. But if somehow you forget to correct those particular mistakes in a revised return, then a revised return can also be revised. There is no doubt about this. So at end, my dear friends, I think that most of your queries on the revised return would have got solved through this particular video. In case of any queries further, you may write to me. Thank you very much for being with me. Wishing you all the best. Jai Hind.